So in Countdown SNK 2, you could customize your character. Well, do a color edit. So as you see, you got triple R up there. Got caught. A lot of people didn't like this game. I liked it. Thought it was a pretty good game. It's a little orange. Like color-wise, I don't know why that was. Gonna corner trap this guy, I guess. Well, as you can see, I used Ken for the color swap or the color edit. Lento. So I like this game a lot. I like them more than the first one play-wise, but I think the first one actually looked better. This one had more characters and it was kind of easier to pull off special moves. I think they did drop the ball on like the graphics and like how there's an overall orange look. Like I said, could be a little bit better. I like the color edit swap. I do think the first one was a bit cleaner, had a really cool like stage introductions in that one. Both games are good. If you're a Street Fighter fan or a SNK fan, I think you'll dig it. I'm not sure why it's not as popular as some of the other ones. Like I said, I didn't see any tournament-wise kind of stuff. There's like chains you can do or unblockable annoying stuff that always breaks these kind of games. But it's a fun game. It's easy to play, pick up. You can do 3-on-3, you can do ratio, you can do single. So, a couple options for a fighting game. Too short. Comes uppercut. Guess not. Triple R wins again. Thank you.
Thank you.
So there you have Capcom versus SNK 2. It's the end stage right here. Sometimes doing different things to meet a requirement will bring out Rugal or Akuma.